Woody Whitelaw joins us now from South Africa.
Yeah.
Hey, guys, how are you? Great to hear your voices.
Well, great to see you, mate. Congratulations. I have to say that you seemed utterly starving, like more than anyone else. You were drinking bean juice, you were scraping iron off the frying pan, as you just admitted. Just how hungry did you get in there?
The hungriest I have ever been. I was getting consistent head spins because my blood sugars were so low. Oh. I just felt weak, almost like I had the flu for, like, I'm going to say, the final 3 weeks I was in there. So it hit me early. So anything was food. I'm not sure if this was actually captured on the TV show, but after an eating trial, I actually tried to sneak animal testicles back to the camp so I could fry those bad boys up and get a decent meal.
Are you joking? You would actually eat them just to have?
Yeah, 100%. I actually ate 2.5 of them during the eating trial. People might remember that eating trial actually for a far bigger story, which was Dom from MAFS really tearing shreds off Kerri-Anne Kennerley. But because I was so uncomfortable during that confrontation and hungry, I just decided to eat all the testicles that were laid out on the table and then discreetly snuck them into my pockets in the hope to fry them up back at the camp. So I think that paints a pretty good picture as to just how hungry I was.
Well, Woody, you had front row seats to that fight. We do have a rule in our household that we never fight about testicles at the table. Were you so distracted by the testicles there that you paid no attention to the fight itself?
No, I was definitely paying attention to the fight, but it really did feel like I was the child watching Mummy and Daddy have a fight. And because I was so uncomfortable with the confrontation, I thought the best thing to do was eat testicles to try and lighten the mood. And now that I've experienced it, actually, if anyone does see a great confrontation or great fight, a testicle really does complement the fight incredibly well. So two thumbs up from me.
You've got lots of reasons to get back home, including your baby daughter. How hard was it to leave her for the jungle? And are you looking forward to those baby snuggles?
That was genuinely the hardest thing about this entire experience. I had a breakdown about 4 days in, and luckily Liz Ellis was there to be a shoulder to cry on as I just bawled my eyes out just thinking about the time that I was missing with my beautiful little girl, Remy. But I would say the only thing that really got me through was the fact that I did have her umbilical cord around my neck through the whole experience. So when I was missing her too much, I knew I could clutch onto that one, and I'm sure everyone finds that a tiny bit weird. But, yeah, mate, cool that she was always with me.
You've just told us you quite like eating testicles. That's nothing.
Seriously, I'm really painting a weird picture.
I heard the word umbilical cord. I came straight in.
Woody has been so amazing in the jungle, but I just wanted to let you guys know that tonight we are going to be honouring the doctor because, as you know, on the grand finale night on Sunday for our big finale, it is the doctor's last show in the jungle. So tonight, in a very huge character departure, I think I might even get quite sincere, guys, but I've already got a massive packet of tissues underneath my little desk there. I hope if I let the balloon go, I'm telling you. Mm. Anyone who can't swim, grab a chair. I'm going to cry for Australia. Anyway, back to Woody. See you on the show.
See you, Julia.
Well, how's that for a tease? There's so much coming up. More celeb action tonight right after us, leading up to the big finale this Sunday, of course, Chris's finale, among other things. Woody, thanks so much for your time, mate. Great to speak.
No worries. Thank you so much, guys. Cheers.